Goggles reviews with me, Terry Kay. I've got one from our mates from the Fordham Brewing Company, I believe. I ain't going to tip it about too much, but I've got a dusty one a little bit. So I'm kind of hoping for good things. It's a little bit dusty round the neck and round this and that. Don't know if you can pick that up there, a little bit dusty. But you know what, that don't mean nothing. It just means it's being kept somewhere, like safe, hopefully. I don't really mind that, if it's been looked after, if it's been kept in the cool. But it is an oyster stout. Now, oysters, some beers that claim to be oyster stouts, Marsden's oyster stout, got no oysters in it. You know, it's no oysters at all. Other ones have had oysters put in. It's been being done oysters for ages, since 1929, I believe, they've been putting them in. And it's supposed to add a bit of brininess, a bit of saltiness and brine sort of qualities that you get from oysters. Once upon a time, oysters were so cheap, pie and mash shops and that, the pies was oysters and eel pies and things like that. Eels and oysters were just like cheap as chips. It was cheaper than meat and everything else, you know. So you used to kind of be able to like farm them down in the Thames and everything else, you know, pick them up even wild in the Thames. So they was very cheap. Now they're quite expensive, you know, but so adding them to beer was kind of like cheap as chips. It was cheaper than putting salt in or putting whatever in, you know. I kind of think that there might be something else involved as well. Kind of like our seaweed can be used for clearing beers and things like that, and certain other things. You know, you get like, you know, fish bladders as well, same sort of thing. You know, eyes and glass and that. Sorry, that noise is me going, this got to be oiled. I'm sorry, you know. I'll oil it before the next one. But I can't sit still. I was looking in, probably the best book in the world is the old Garrett Oliver edited, The Oxford Companion to Beer. Fantastic book. Looked in there at oysters, looked it up, nothing! So that was kind of a letdown from my all-time favourite book of all time. But let's get on with this. This is Fordham's Rosie Parks Oyster Stout. Now, I don't know Rosie Park. I know Rosa Parks, but I don't know Rosie Park, so I don't know what the kind of thing is for that. Let's have a little look. The legendary skipjack Rosie Parks once dredged. Oh, so it was a ship. Hence the picture of the sailboat there, or boat. I think the only thing that's considered a ship in real life is the lifeboats. I think they're the only thing considered a ship. I'm not sure. Someone will tell me on that. I think everything else is a boat. Anyway, dredged for oysters on the Cheapspeak Bay. Once the famous fastest of the fleet, and a beauty to behold. She is now undergoing restoration. Cool. At the Cheapspeak, Chesapeake, is it? Or something like that. Bay Maritime Museum. In honour of Rosie's history, this 5.2% ABV stout contains Chesapeake. Oh, I've got that right. Bay oyster shells. So it's probably not quite as dangerous as keeping oysters for too long, you know. I don't know. I don't know what happens when you bottle them. Is it the same as canned stuff? I don't know. You know, you can stuff and you can keep it for ages, you know. You've got canned pilchards and things like that, you know. You know, and you, when you get these Zurstrung, they have to start letting it go off before they can it, you know. Anyway, I do digress. Let's pour this out, because I'm looking forward to this. It looks kind of quite lovely. There is the little FO, the old Fordham's. Beautiful there. From, where is it? Cool, whereabouts is it? Is it Queen Mary or something? Queen's? I don't know. I've completely forgotten. But let's pour this out. Most important thing is the beer. Oh, it smells lovely. Here's the beer, what it smells like, what it tastes like. History and kind of like that, stuff like that is interesting. It does sometimes enrich, and, you know, your view of the beer, you know, what that you're drinking. And it makes things interesting. I'm going to slap the cap on that. All right. To look after that for later, and keep it in the fridge till, like, maybe later or tomorrow or something. I might have it like later on, I don't know. But anyway, this is what it looks like. Should I just twirl a little bit of a head in, because I've concentrated on not pouring one. I'm pouring it right. Forgot myself, thought I was pouring it for myself. And you guys like to see a head, so I twizzle one in. There's a little light head in there. It's not really massive. Kind of gripping just gradual to the glass. It's not massive, it's not big. It's probably one of the things that are probably helping to kill that down will be the salts in the briny kind of oils and that and stuff that come and liquids that come out from the shells and from the oysters themselves. So they'll probably be killing it, because one way to kill a head on a beer is just wipe a little bit of the greasy oils and salt and sweat and that off yourself, dip your finger in, twirl it around, and the head's gone in seconds, like that is. You know, so it's doing a bit of uphill fighting there, so I'm worried, you know. So, but it's dark, and also when you've got little head, look at the surface. If you can see the surface, if the head's died down enough, you'll see the carbonation, a healthy carbonation. It looks like rain on the surface. It looks like you're a big giant and there's a miniature like pond somewhere with rain spittering on it. And it's just little tiny pip, 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 pip every now and again as a bubble breaks the surface. Pip, 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 pip. And you can just about see that breaking the surface. Little dip, 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 dip. It's lovely, really pretty, as the light bounces off. Right, let's have a sniff. Lovely little chocolatey notes, all them lovely dark little aromas. Lovely dark sort of chocolatey notes. Little latte, gentle coffee, something kind of gentle Americano sort of thing, but a gentle sort of blend. That's really lovely, that is really nice. Little hints, as you twirl it, you get little hints of something licorice-y just popping up out there, like a dark licorice. The wood, the licorice wood that you get when you soak it if you can make different drinks, and they're really good for getting rid of colds and things, but you soak up, I don't like Coca-Cola, but one of the things that I do is, if I've got a cold, I'll get some lemon juice, fresh out the lemon in it, I'll get some Coca-Cola, I'll heat up the Coca-Cola, chuck the lemon juice in there and put a bit of cinnamon and a bit of licorice, a licorice stick in there, and let it cool itself down and then drink it down, you know. And it's really, really lovely and really good for you. It's got that in there, it's kind of little notes of that, sarsaparilla almost as well. That's pretty, that is nice. Right, bubbles up, chin chin, cheers everyone. Oh, Christ. Ooh, that's lovely. See, sometimes I make a slurpy noise. I've got like I'd be useless at playing poker. I've got one of these faces that as I'm enjoying something, suddenly it goes, I'm kind of enjoying something when I can't control the lips going out like that. But that is really lovely. There's a slight thin aftertaste with it. It's a little bit thin, kind of, it's not boisterous and buoyant. But while you're swallowing it, while you're drinking it, oh man, I'm going to go in again. Oh, wow. That is lovely. I might bring these notes to you. You're getting the same thing as the licorice. You're getting that wood again. That's bitter sort of licorice. Not the sweet sort of sweetie twirls and things like that, and the little Bertie Bassets and whatever else. This is a kind of a much more attacking sort of an expectorant almost, you know, kind of like these Benelines and things like that. That bitter edge to it. Sort of little bitter clove edges, as if you kind of ain't sweet, got them sweetened up in it. Excuse me. Pardon me. A slight little creamy little background note. I'm not getting much out of the brine. Tiny little hints of salt on a really kind of just sticking around on the tongue, like you've dipped your finger in the crisp bag and or the salt out of peanuts or something, that sort of thing. You don't do that. You're far too posh, you people. But it's very, very, very subtle. But the rest of it, there's some big old chocolate notes. Lovely big chocolate notes. Kind of like them peanut chocolates. When you get a dark chocolate with the peanutty bits in there as well. And maybe little spicy notes as well in there. That is really nice. I like that. Right. The rest of that will be going down in a little bit. But Fuldham's Oyster Stout, definitely one to try that one. Try it, buy it, bum bum bum, bum 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 bum. Try it, buy it, and like it. That is lovely. You really will like that one, I tell you. So give it a go. And it comes in a nice big bottle. That's what I like. Now, these are the sort of bottles you're supposed to share. In it, you try getting one of these off me, no, ain't gonna happen. Right, see you all later, all. See you in the next one. Don't be late. Biddly boo. Over the band to the wave, with the wave.